I'd like to say hello to all my brothers and sisters at Local 717 in Elyon, New York. We've been friends, brothers, sisters for many, many years now. We are now approaching another conflict, if you may, or a struggle that we have to deal with, and that is the most recent bankruptcy filing by Remington in the Northern Bankruptcy Court in Alabama and Birmingham. And I want you to know a couple of things before we move forward here. One is bankruptcy is not a good place for anybody to be that works for a living, and I think you already know that. But we have been through 10 years of this. We've seen some of the largest coal companies in America file for bankruptcy, and quite frankly, given the nature of bankruptcy, we've done fairly well at the end of the day. Generally, a Chapter 11 filing, which is what has happened here, there is an intent to have a reorganization and come out on the other end with the current owners operating the facilities at the end of the day. That is not what is happening here. There was a hearing today, and you were represented in court by UMWA attorney in Birmingham named Scott Williams out of a large firm in Birmingham that specializes in bankruptcy. Our goal would be that at the end of the day, you still are employed by whoever operates the facility at Elyon. And that's a big if right there, if somebody's going to operate it. We don't know the answer to that yet. This company intends to sell all of its assets, pay off its debt, and at the end of the day, be completed with this process on a very, very expedited, in a very expedited manner, I should say, by the end of September. That's a really, really fast schedule for bankruptcy. Normally, under normal circumstances, there is a duty to bargain with the union if there is a collective bargaining agreement in place. And that duty exists in this situation too, because you have a collective bargaining agreement. We are your representative. But because it's a sale, if indeed the buyer agrees to take the employees and the collective bargaining agreement that's in place, there would not be a necessity to bargain. They currently have a number of companies interested in buying the assets. Now, the problem we have here is obvious. We don't know if they're talking about buying all of the assets or if they have more than one company wanting to buy particular assets. We do know this. Based on the pleadings that I mentioned before, Elyon and the operation out in Alabama are the two greatest generator of revenue for the company. So what you do and what you've been producing, and Elyon has made money for the owners over many, many years. Remington has a good name in the firearms industry. And everyone knows you make a great product. I just want you to know for one thing for certain, they're not going to take your jobs and close this plant or walk away from you without the damnedest fight they've ever been in. And I want you to engage in that fight along beside us. Our goal here is for you to keep your jobs and to keep a UMWA contract in place there. We don't have total control of that. But we're going to use every political asset we have, every legal asset that we have, and we're in this fight with you. So brothers and sisters, this is not what you were looking for. You were not looking for someone to come along and start shopping your company. You didn't look for this bankruptcy to be filed, but it did happen. So what we have to do is contend with what's in front of us. We've got a lot of experience with this. Unfortunately, most of it's turned out all right. But we're in this fight together. United we stand, divided we fall, wrong to ones or wrong to all. And we're gonna be right there by your side, just like we've been beside everybody else that's been through this process. God bless all of you.